Watch out, Islanders.
It's the season opener, the Sharks and the Islanders, tomorrow at 7:30 on 36 KICU.
The Sharks are hungry.
The following is a 36 KICU sports presentation.
In downtown San Jose, it was a summer of heavy-duty construction. The same can be said for the San Jose Sharks. 9 new players, along with a new coaching staff led by Al Sins, will be the most visible aspects of this summer-long reconstruction. And tonight, a chance to cash in that first dividend as the 1996-97 season gets set to break the ice at San Jose Arena. The new edition of the San Jose Sharks meet the Atlantic Division's New York Islanders next on 36 KICU. San Jose Arena, the 1996-97 National Hockey League season starts its engines. Looking for dramatic improvement over last year, the San Jose Sharks get ready for the challenge. Tonight, in the season opener, they meet up with the New York Islanders. It's a brand new year with a brand new coach, 43-year-old Al Sims. Some final words before the new-look San Jose Sharks step onto the ice here at San Jose Arena. Hi again, everybody. I'm Randy Hahn. Welcome to another season, season number 6 of Sharks Hockey here on 36 KICU. We are live at the tank as the Sharks get set to get it all going again with the visiting New York Islanders tonight. A lot on the line and a lot at stake as the Sharks try and get back to where they ought to be in the National Hockey League playoffs after having a less than spectacular season last year in the NHL, a season that everybody would like to forget. And that's the beauty of pro sports. It all starts over again just one season later. Lots of new things. We're going to be talking about them all night, not the least of which, I have a brand new partner. You know him from radio. He joins us on television this season as our color commentator, Chris Collins. And Chris, I know you are bursting at the seams about this season because there's a lot to be excited about after all the changes.
Well, there really are. You know, Dean Lombardi brought in veterans. And I think with veterans over an 82-game season, which is quite long, unlike football, you get wise decision-making. And I think with the veterans like the Bernie Nichols and the Al Iafredis, you're going to get that wise decision-making. I like the chances the Sharks are having this year, at least on paper. They look like they've got good decision makers out on the ice.
And one of the things Dean Lombardi wanted to do as he addressed all the problems was to bring in players that competed each and every night, and it seems he's done that.
Well, he really has. When you look, let's look at the goal out. He brought in Chris Terreri last year in a tough situation, but with the right people in front of him, Chris Terreri is a game maker. So is Kelly Rudy, who they acquired from the Los Angeles Kings, and he gets his chance tomorrow night going back to the place he spent quite a number of years. So really some guys that can go out and make things happen.
Each and every spot through the lineup has a lot of character. And talking about a character, S.J. Sharkey back in the house here at the tank. He's got something new cooked up every year when the season opens. What's this all about? Hang on, buddy! Right out of here, S.J. Sharkey. He gets a 10.0 for execution and artistic impression. A spectacular start to the season for S.J., and hopefully it's a little of a prophetic leading into the kind of season that the San Jose Sharks hope starts right here at the arena tonight. Well, that was something new from Sharkey. We have lots of new things. We'll begin to unravel all of it right now as we introduce you in our Cellular One studios to Ted Rowlands. Ted?
Okay, Randy, thanks a lot. We are thrilled to be back for another year of Sharks hockey here on KICU. We've got a brand new Cell One studio, as you can see, one that should afford us a lot of time throughout the season. We've got a big show for you tonight. We're going to talk live with Owen Nolan in between the first and second period. There are 11 games in the NHL.